Weeks ago, I published a new interview on my blog. You can go check it out at thegearconfessions.com. But in it, I interviewed Tom Cram from Spiral Electric Effects. Now, I first met Tom several years ago when he was working with the Harmon Group at DoD Pedals, and he was the guy who was almost single-handedly responsible for bringing that brand back to life. He introduced a bunch of cool pedals, but my favorite among them was the Carcosa Fuzz. It was wild and gated and spitty and really kind of textural and awesome. But my favorite thing about it was sort of the bloom quality that would happen when you would sort of hit that low E string and, you know, it would sort of swell into fullness, and it was amazing. And so I wasn't at all surprised that when I plugged this guy in, the Brood Fuzz, that it basically does the same thing. Now, this isn't as crazy or as wild as the Carcosa. It's really kind of more straightforward fuzz tones, but it's got a silicon germanium transistor in there, some nanolog technology that you can go read about on Tom's website. But when I plugged it in, I flipped it to the germanium setting, rolled the bias all the way back and the gain all the way up. And what happened was that unwillingly started playing the riff you just heard from the Foo Fighters, because it kind of just nails that low E string a lot. And my goodness, it sounds amazing. In fact, I told Tom that if this pedal was only their germanium section, it would be worth it. But you get so much more out of it, and I try to demonstrate a little bit of that in what you just heard. So if you like it, go check out Tom's stuff, Spiral Electric. Of course, go to my blog, read our interview, and all the other interviews that are there. You can do that at thegearconfessions.com. But yeah, until next time, thanks for watching, and see you again later.